everyone, and welcome to the Good News and Notes with Pastor Phil. We'll be looking at scripture, its meaning, interpretation, how it affects our life, and also we're going to see how the world of music amplifies the good news. So let's buckle up and jump right in.
Hey, everyone, and thank you for joining me back for the Good News and Notes with Pastor Phil. Today, we're doing something a little different, and I wanted to take a look at the song Amazing Grace for a particular reason. Well, this is a song written in the late 1700s by a clergyman named John Newton. He's said to be 1772 and is very popular in the United States, especially for funerals. No surprise there. It was put to paper around Christmas time, and it speaks about the joys of being saved through faith by grace. And it was not till 60 years later that it was put to music in what is said to be New Britain. It makes me think maybe New Britain, Connecticut. I wanted to listen to it now because we are entering into the season of Pentecost with the church, or we could say Pentecost Sunday, the birthday of the church. For me, the song is so inspirational that I can feel the Holy Spirit working through the lyrics and the melody itself. But actually, in all honesty, I kind of got bored with this song over the years till I heard this group come out with this particular version. They rebooted this song for me, so to speak, and I can say that the Holy Spirit works through these angelic voices as they use their God-given talents to brighten so many people, and especially during this time of COVID. I have to say that this song dropped into our laps at just the perfect time around Christmas. So let's listen.
Amazing grace, how sweet the sound that saved
stop here. That way we can go onto YouTube. What a gorgeous entrance on that, Joan, on the tonic with Kirsten and I believe maybe Kevin or Matt. I mean, it almost sounded like they were reenacting the bagpipes, setting that key in that moment for the entrance by Matt with the solo. And then Mitch comes in with that rich harmony that was just so tight and perfectly placed. And then again, of course, we go into the trio, which I think was Scott. I mean, it just layered perfectly, setting that tone and that that timing to come into the next verse. So it's just a powerful opening, and what they do with those vowels all together, just lining them up and shaping them perfectly, just wonderful.
'Twas grace that taught my heart to fear. And grace my fears relieve. How precious did that grace appear the hour I first believed. My chains are gone, I've been saved.
We'll get to it, but just what they do here. The transition into Mitch's entrance here, but those, I guess you'd call them arpeggiating, to call them pizzicatos, do-do-do-do, and they're moving from the O's to the A's. It just adds that push forward, and you, to me, you can almost hear that Holy Spirit breathing onto them and through each note that they sing. It's just beautiful. They fill the sound each time. So here, wow, they just fill that church up right there. And how appropriate it is that we're talking about the Holy Spirit when they are singing right there, the sun coming through, their voice is filling that space. And when they're restating those phrases that Mitch is singing and just adding that strength to it, the answer is my chains are gone. The song just takes off. And of course, especially with the percussion in the background and the hands clapping, the foot stomping, just taking that motion forward. But you know, many say that the song comes through, the power comes when Mitch comes in with his beautiful voice, and it is beautiful. But I personally think what makes this song most of the time is Kirsten's voice. And she just rises into the stratosphere and doubles his parts and backs him up and adds that special bright color. Because again, she is the only female in the group. And so her voice is unique. And it kind of, I just put it out there, it aggravates me many times when many people talk about the individual voices, which of course each one could be a lead singer in any group. But her voice, I don't think Pentatonix would be Pentatonix without her voice being interlaced into the harmonies that they put out there. I'm just throwing that out there because she backs up Mitch's voice there. And that, I think, is what makes that moment even more special. And Scott putting his energy in there with the middle range, of course. And we can't forget the bass line, the walking or moving, descending bass line, doo, 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 supporting the pitches. And with the grace, it's just perfect precision. And then we again, that descending line with the Mitch's descending line at the end there, which I'm guessing leads directly right into Kirsten's solo. So let's get moving here. As it modulates, of course, because they are the masters of modulation and transitions.
The earth shall soon dissolve like snow. The sun forbear.
Word, what a gorgeous crystal clear voice, and everything that she sings, she owns it with her emotion, the power, everything that drives through her. And again, supported by the entire group with the beast entrance coming in and eventual to the descending line is incredible. But wow. And then notes just suspend out there in unison. And just suspends. And then again, the masters of their tricks, silence. And moves into the tagline at the end. So let's finish. Oh, I also forgot to say the vibrato she uses is perfect. It adds right into who she is. And I forgot to say at the very beginning with Scott too, the two of them together with the vibrato and their technique, they're just amazing. There they go. That's what they do. So, friends, wow. Just wow. And then, of course, at the end, we know Kevin can sing. He's just a phenomenal talent in music on just about everything. No surprise there. But just wow. I mean, I am moved every single time I hear this group sing. The way they bring their individual talents into one cohesive group, working together to build that wall of sound by just five people. I mean, to many people probably can't understand what such discipline, hard work, and energy it takes to sing like this. The training is just to be able to breathe properly is second to none. And what a gift it is to hear the way they listen to each other, the way they communicate when they sing, the way they use their bodies. And of course, in the video, I have to say, like the other ones, where they record these videos is just also hard work and put things together. They are just talented. So, Holy Spirit, wow. It moves through this group. It blessed these people with these gifts to be able to share the talent of music with us, the communication of faith and grace through faith alone. And as we heard in these lyrics, they said it. We look at how blessed we are with freedom from sin, the gift of grace through faith alone. So friends, I invite you to listen to this. I'll post the link up there and listen to it over and over again the rest of this week as we enter into the Sunday of Pentecost, and bless you all.
And there you have it, everyone. Thank you for joining us, and please join us again next time for the good news and the notes with Pastor Phil. Thank you, and goodbye.